Pearson, may I be the first to congratulate you.
My appeal
has been upheld. Your husband's on his way down to get you now.
Oh, Edna, that's wonderful. Great.
Hi, everybody. Edna's going to be released. Let's hear it for her. Hip, hip.
Hooray.
Hip, hip.
We made a deal. And I don't take too kindly to people who back down on deals, if that's what you're doing. Either you keep your end of the bargain or I shout so loud they're going to hear me in bloody Darwin. Did you get me?
Oh, I feel like I've got a knife in me gut.
Well, that does it then. If the cook is crooked, we're all in trouble.
I'm serious, dude. Would you get me some help?
Oh, come off it, rabbit. We got a lot.
Yes, of course, Mrs. Reynolds. She'll be all right. They've called Dr. Trimbarth in to check her over just in case.
Have you any idea what brought it on?
Well, symptoms definitely point to some sort of poisoning, but I can't find any sign of a bite, so she must have ingested it.
The meat?
No, I don't think so. We'd have a lot more cases. You know, it's strange. I had Harvey and Jenkins down with similar symptoms yesterday, but it can't be coming from the kitchen, or we'd have everyone sick.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see what the doctor says. Mm. Can I have a few words with Warren?
Sure, I'll just be next door in case you need me.
Right. You feeling any better, Marlene?
Yes, thanks, bit.
Got any idea what made you sick?
Yeah, the meat. It's the only thing she could have got hold of.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that she tried to poison me.
Who? Are you sure you're not just letting your imagination run away with you?
Look, I know it sounds silly, Mrs. R, but it's not the first time she's... Oh, what the hell? Jude thought I was off with the fairies, too.
Marlene, it's not that I don't believe you, but how can I even check your story out if you won't tell me who's trying to poison you?
Can't say. It's dumb, isn't it?
Yes, it is. All right, you get some rest.
There's your mate with a gut ache.
Oh, it's not like you to be concerned, Winter.
We're not. Just glad she's getting some of her own for a change. She's been giving me a gut ache for weeks.
Jude, how's my leave?
I don't know. Myra's trying to find out. I was just saying goodbye to Edna.
Oh, yeah, lucky bitch. Now, every time someone gets out, it reminds me how long I'm going to be stuck in his dump.
Hey, come on, don't be like that. You admitted that you did it. You're not going to stick your way forever. And you had good reason. They'll take that into account.
Yeah, they'll just take your license away so you can't run down any more pedestrians.
Why don't you shut up?
Yeah, shut your mouth, Fran. Let the Yank do all the wishful thinking.
Oh, bitches. She's right, though. No way I'll be let off.
Well, Marlene must be okay. She's still here. Food poisoning or something.
Hey, you all right, Lou? She's getting her own back.
Must have drunk some of her own barley water.
God, do you think she was telling the truth?
What?
You feel like a cuppa?
No, after the news, thanks, love.
Okay, well, I'm going to go and see how my name is.
Oh, wish you luck. They wouldn't let me in.
Yeah, but I've just developed a shocking headache. Oh, Mr. Cruikshank, I'm glad you're here. Could I go and get some aspirin? I got a real banging headache.
Oh, sorry, Brian. I'd have to wait. The governor wants to see you. You too, Mitchell.
Wonder what Mrs. R wants them for.
Maybe she's found a way of getting rid of the rubbish around here. That's three down, two to go.
Hey, watch it.
Now, if you don't learn to shut your mouth, Winter, the next time I do that, it'll be with your face.
I'm so scared.
You've got good reason to be.
Yeah? Well, you better make the most of it, Desmond, because you're not going to be playing top dog games around here much longer.
Oh? Like to tell me why?
And spoil the surprise. You ought to know by now that's not my style. Righto, ladies. You got a bit of cleaning up to do. Your top dog just made a mess on the floor.
Now, that's three people, Judy, in 2 days. Of course, Warren's the only one claiming she was deliberately poisoned, but Sister thinks they could be linked.
Yeah, well, it's possible.
Oh?
Look, at first, I didn't believe Marlene when she was saying that someone had spiked her drink, but, well, it's all looking a bit sus now.
Did she say who it might have been?
Yeah, But I think it's a stab in the dark. I mean, that person would have no reason.
Was it Bobbie Mitchell?
Of course not. Now, just a minute. Is that why you've got Bobbie outside? You couldn't believe that Bobbie'd have anything to do with it, Mrs. Reynolds.
We've got to face facts, Judy. Mrs. Barry told me it was Bobbie who cooked Marlene's steak.
Well, that doesn't prove anything.
I know. But it doesn't look good when you link up the poisonings. Just remember, Harvey and Jenkins are friends of Kean's, and Warren shares Mitchell's cell. It's quite probable she's trying to get rid of anyone who could give evidence about her attack on Kean.
Well, she didn't attack Kean.
I'm sorry, Judy. The police don't believe that, and I don't think they're going to believe she's innocent of this either.
Uh-huh. Good on you, Edna. And the battle over
hairpairs for today. How's that all about?
Just giving Edna a second send-off. Her release made the news. Well, obviously you haven't got good news from Mrs. R.
No, I haven't. Mrs. Reynolds thinks that Marlene was deliberately poisoned.
Is she all right?
Yeah.
Well, does she know who did it?
She thinks Bobbie did it.
Oh, come on, Bobbie. What did you talk her out of it?
No.
Oh, hell, the poor kid.
But who would want to poison Marlene?
Yesterday, she said that Edna tried to poison her.
Oh, but why? When her appeal was coming up.
Her appeal. Obviously, the rabbit has seen or heard something she shouldn't have, and Edna's tried to stop her from blowing a story.
Yeah, and do you realize that that makes Edna as guilty as hell? Thank God she isn't here.
You're joking. Now everyone believes she's innocent. She'll probably try again on Dear Harry.
So where's the rope?
Pardon?
Well, you all reckon I tried to poison Rabbit, don't you? So why don't you get a rope?
Calm down, Bobbie. No one believes that bull.
That's right, love. We know who did it. We're going to back your story all the way so they don't pin it on you.
Oh, you two-faced bitch. It was you who lagged to the screws. Well, you did pretty good, lady, because now they're trying to lumber me with three attempted murders. You hear that? Three!
Bobbie, come on.
Better if I talk to her.
Oh, God.
Don't tell me there's trouble in the camp.
Just shut up, Mari. Don't worry, Jude. There must be some way we can prove it was Edna.
Yeah, sure.
Jane, dinner.
Yeah, coming.
Oh, come on, mate. It'll get cold. Well, I caught you red-handed this time, didn't I?
But I'm not taking nothing.
I might have been a fool to believe that you were above stealing yesterday, but I'd have to be an utter idiot not to believe my own eyes, boy.
But stealing it. I'm putting it back. It's true. Okay, I did steal it yesterday, but now I'm putting it back. I wouldn't have done it, only I thought you weren't getting nothing for me birthday. I told me mates how you're getting me something real beaut. I'm sorry. It was dumb.
Yeah, it was dumb. But it doesn't cancel out the fact that you took it yesterday.
Yeah, I know.
Right. Well, I won't punish you this time because you were honest about it. After you were caught, anyway. But if it ever happens again, you won't get off so lightly.
Gee, thanks, Auntie Jane. I'll never do it again. Cross me heart.
Okay, let's eat.
Hey, do you reckon we'll have time to go to Luna Park after tea?
Oh, get out of that kitchen! Go on, get out.
Anyone heard how Warren is this morning?
Oh, yeah, sorry, forgot. Elaine said she's bouncing around the hospital with this to get out.
Take a lot to keep that one down.
Hi, love, what did Mrs. M want?
Mrs. Cops after breakfast.
Don't worry, they can't pin the poisoning on you.
Oh, why not? They didn't have any trouble blaming me for trying to kill Reb.
Come on, honey, we're working on that.
Yeah, we just have to find something that'll convince them it was Edna.
Oh, geez, you lot make me laugh. There's no way you can prove that. So how the hell are you going to prove it wasn't me? I cooked rabbit's meat, remember?
We're going to have to do something quick, otherwise she'll admit to it just to get everyone off her back.
Can't we go to Mrs. Reynolds? It can't be lagging if Edna's gone, can it?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't care if it was lagging. All I'm interested in is Bobbie.
Oh, spare a thought for Edna's husband.
God, yeah, she's probably giving him breakfast right now. Well, for Pete's sake, we have to ring him. Warn him or something.
He's not going to believe us. Even the courts couldn't convince him.
We have to at least let him know what happened in here. It'll be up to him if he wants to believe it or not.
Going to see Mrs. Reynolds after breakfast.
Yeah, I wouldn't mention the phone call to Harry, though. I don't think she'll go along with it.
I am going to see her about Bobbie. That is top priority. We'll worry about Harry later.
Oh, come on, Shane, you'll be late for school.
Do I have to? I feel real crook.
Oh, mate, the only way you'll get a day off is if you break out in purple spots.
I'm not kidding. My throat's real sore and I've got a real bad headache.
Let me check. Let's see. Oh, yeah. No wonder you feel off. I think you've got a temperature.
Then I can stay home.
Better still, you can go to bed. I think you're in for a bout of the flu. I'll ring work and tell them I can't make it.
I'm not a baby. Jeez, Honey Jane.
All right. But you stay rugged up and I'll ring you at lunchtime to see how you are.
Go on. You better buzz off or you'll be late.
All right, I'm going. And you, straight to bed.
So what proof do you have?
Well, none, really. Just that Marlene was scared silly for days before the last attack.
And we know it wasn't Bobbie, Mrs. Reynolds.
You gotta help her. Miss Ferguson won't lift a finger to help her when she takes over.
We don't know yet that Miss Ferguson will be taking over, Judy, and I can't drop these charges, nor can my replacement, just on the say-so of Mitchell's friends.
Well, then why can't you at least take our word about the barley water? Edna had to have fixed that.
Please, Mrs. Reynolds, you've got nothing to prove it was Bobbie. You have to believe us.
I'd like to, Milsom. But it seems all too convenient to point to Edna Pearson as soon as a poisoning happens. I only hope for everyone's sake that Bobbie isn't trying to use her as a scapegoat. She certainly had more motive than Edna for the poisonings.
Yeah, but you can't...
No,
believe...
Judy, I'm sorry. There's nothing I can do.
Hi. Got a minute?
If it's up to the cops, I've got 30 years.
They didn't believe you about Marlene.
Why should they? I'm the person who goes around pushing people downstairs, remember?
I'm really sorry
oh,
about...
Oh, sure you're sorry, Reb. You're all heart. That's why you got me in this mess, isn't it? Because you figured I liked the place so much I wouldn't want to leave.
Yeah, well, the cops got it wrong. Look, I've even told Reno it wasn't you.
Oh, how'd you expect me to swallow that? I'm still on a charge for it.
Look, I can't help that. Go ask her if you don't believe me.
So you told her I didn't do it? So you told her who did do it, right?
Oh, I can't lag.
Just tell me who did it. I'll fix the bitch.
I can't. Look, I'm sorry, but I can't. I know they're coming down heavy on you. I've tried to fix it. Honestly, if I
could... I'll stuff your stupid excuses!
Oh, Miss Rogers. I don't believe I've thanked you properly for saving my life during the riot.
Pardon? Well, I guess it was just lucky that I turned up when I did, eh?
Oh, I'd say it was a little more than luck. You know... At first, I was rather worried that you might not be able to handle this job. However, I'm very happy to say that I was proved wrong.
Thank you.
In fact, it'll be a pleasure to have a young, competent officer like yourself on the team when I take over the governor's seat.
It'll all be pretty much of a muchness, won't it? I mean, the rules and all will stay the same when Mrs. Reynolds goes.
Oh, there will be a difference, of course. Now, the rules won't change, but I'll be seeing that they are carried out to the letter.
Won't be easy with some of the troublemakers we've got.
On the contrary. Anyone who doesn't toe the line gets shipped straight to Blackmore.
That means Winter doesn't have a hope.
Oh, that one's ticket is already booked.
That's good news at least.
Well, it should have been done at the first sign of trouble, and that, Miss Rogers, is what I mean about things being run properly when I take over.
Miss Ferguson, that reminds me. Knowing you're such a stickler for the rules and all, why didn't you hit the riot alarm when the ruckus started? I mean, you were right there, weren't you?
I didn't have much of a chance, did I, with those animals beating me senseless?
Yeah. Right.
Rachel, get to phone Harry.
Yeah, she's there now. God, I hope there aren't too many H. Pearsons in the phone book, but I'm pretty sure Edna said they lived in Waddleton. Mm. I wish I'd been in the staff room where Mrs. Barry's brother looked.
Fancy buying a story like that.
Well, why not? Everybody uses phone books to do bust exercises. Almost everybody. Can we get a checkers?
No, I think even checkers is beyond me today.
Myra,
is something bothering you?
No, love, just the opposite. Kay's gone back to school and she's got a part-time job as a cashier.
Oh, that's great news.
But now Mum pays the price. I face the VJ day after tomorrow.
Oh, God, I'm sorry. I forgot all about that. Yeah. Well, let's hope it's Bateman. At least he's got some sort of heart.
Yeah. Hey, Bryant, heard what they're going to do to your scissor happy friend?
Listen, Kelly, how would you like your teeth shoved down your throat?
Are either going to pack Mitchell off to a mate in the loony bin?
Bitches, can't wait till me back's turned, can you?
We're not going to turn ours punk. Might get stabbed, bashed or poisoned.
Now, Bobby, that is not going to solve anything.
I'm sick to death of the stinking bitches. Wish they had it packed me off to the madhouse. At least then I'd have cash. He's the only decent mate I've got.
Oh, hang on. That's not true and you know it.
Oh, you lot don't give a stuff about
it. Cut it out, Bobby. We're doing everything we can to get you off that poison charge.
Oh, big deal. You get about as far as you did proving that I didn't push Reb. Anyway, you want to know something else? Reb knows who done it, but she's not saying because she's too scared.
Just a minute. She knows?
Yeah. And I reckon there's one person in this whole place who could turn Reb to jelly, and that's you, Winter. Isn't that right? You're the bitch who pushed Reb, and I'm going to prove it.
That's going to be a bit difficult, Mitchell. I got a screw's word for an alibi, remember? She saw me on the floor above just before she saw you with Kean.
So? Just means you had time to get down before she came.
Oh, God, you must have caught some kind of disease in Sydney. Something's been rotting your brain.
You've got to believe me, front Reb with it or something.
Look, I wouldn't put it past Winter, but if she's got a screw back in her story, there's nothing we can do.
Oh, you gutless bitches. Stuff the lot of you. I know when I got mates and when I haven't.
You better buy her a muzzle next, Bobbie. She's going to be frothing at the mouth next. I wouldn't be so smug if I were you, Winter. If we find out you push Kean down those stairs, you're going to be laughing on the other side of your face. Don't bet on it, sweetheart. One thing your mate was right about, you're gutless. Look at that one.
Mustn't have much. That fig leaf's pretty small.
I wouldn't mind waiting for autumn.
I would.
What do you want?
I just got out of hospital. They're blaming Bobby for making me sick.
So?
Well, yous know the barley water Edna gave me was poison, so I thought if you could tell Renna, it'd get her off the hook.
Why should we? We don't owe you nothing. In fact, you owe us, right, Alice?
Yeah. We heard it was you pinched all our buy-up goods. You got a nerve coming asking us for favours.
They weren't your buy-up goods. I was giving them back to the people that owned them.
Yeah, well, now we're going to show you what playing goody-two-shoes is going to get you. Hold it, Jenk.
I'm warning you, if you touch me, Myra and Judy are going to get you.
Since when?
Since they said they'd keep their eyes open for me in case you decide to pay me back.
Well, we'll just wait until they're out of action. Lard belly, then we'll mop the floor with you.
Come on, before she cacks her pants.
Where the hell are you two been?
Skin on a rabbit.
Well, I said quarter two and I meant it. Now, if you want to stay on the winning side, I suggest you start learning how to tell the time.
Okay. So what gives anyway?
Easy Street, if you're still around to enjoy it. Come next week, we're going to have the sweetest setup any con could dream of.
You got to be kidding. The freak's taken over.
Yeah, I reckon we'll be spending the rest of our time in solitary.
Well, you probably would have if I hadn't been pulling a few strings while you lot sat in your bums. I got Ferguson right where I want. Come next week, we're going to make more money in Wentworth than the place has ever seen before. And all with the blessing of the new governor.
Oh, wow. Good stuff, Murray.
Yeah, as long as Desmond and Bryant don't put a fly in the ointment.
Oh, I fixed that. Ferguson's getting rid of Desmond. And that battery-operated blob's no problem on her own. So from now on, it's going to be open slather on the Wentworth stock market.
Warren reckons they're ready to make mincemeat of us.
Well, I reckon it's about time we ruffled their feathers a bit. They've been getting on my nerves lately.
When do we get them?
You want me to wipe your bum too? I've been doing a lot of overtime lately. Now it's your turn.
Reckon we got time to work up an appetite for lunch.
Anyway, I reckon if Marlene's right and the freak had organised the wrecking, she's probably responsible for the ride as well.
Wouldn't surprise me. The freak's been pushing to get Reno out for ages. Proving it's going to be as hard as clearing Bobby, though.
Hey. Reckon I can help you there if you're interested.
Just shut up, Kelly.
Gee, some mate you'd be. I got the name of the person who did it. And I know just the thing to get her to admit it.
All right, shoot.
In here. Don't want nobody hearing.
Exchanged.
I got the bit of paper that'll nail her.
Better get a move on, Winter. Lunch has already started.
I hope you're not forgetting who gives the orders, Miss Rogers. You know, I was real happy with that last delivery you made. In fact, I'm so proud of you, I'm going to let you do it again.
Like hell, if you think that
now,
I...
Now, don't make any rash statements, sweetheart. Or little brother's going to end up even more mangled than his bike was.
You rotten, low-down scum. God, I'll be glad to see the back end of you.
Don't tell me we're driving you out.
No, you're bloody not. And I'm warning you, if you so much as breathe on my family, my big brother and his copper mates are going to make your life hell where you're going.
What do you mean? Where am I going?
According to Miss Ferguson, you're already halfway to Blackmore. Bon voyage, sweetheart.
God, you must have a cast iron stomach. Couldn't eat for a week if I'd been poisoned.
Jeez, I'm starving. Must have cleaned me out. Did you get hold of poor old Harry?
Yeah,
Hey, you two, I've got your lunches for you. Probably cold by now, but where you been?
Fighting your battles, apparently.
Hey?
The next time you decide to tell the world that we're your guardian angels, would you mind letting us in on it as well?
You don't mean that they...
I do mean Lou, Fran and Alice. At least we left them worse off than we are.
That's terrible. The three of them ganged up on you. Why?
Well, ask Madam here.
Oh, geez, Jude. Myra, I'm sorry. Well, I just told them that to keep them off my back. I didn't know they'd do that. You did say you'd look out for me, Jude.
Yeah, look out for you, but not take your beatings for you. Well, you're very lucky that Wonder Woman and I were in such good form today. We left the three of them with quite a lot of bruises.
Oh, then it all turned out for the best, eh? Well, things around here are really starting to look up. I'll be visiting again next week.
Marlene, things might be looking up for you, but what about Bobby?
Yeah, and I don't want to burst the bubble, but if the freak takes over, privileges like visiting rights might become just a fond memory.
Yeah, all right. Okay, you can make up a bed on the couch, providing you keep yourself covered. Yes. Yeah, well, how do you feel now? Right. Now, Shane, you've got to drink plenty of fluids. Yes, there's plenty of fruit juice in the fridge. Now, Shane, you just keep yourself warm and no mucking about. Do you hear me?
And next time we play darts,
yeah.
I'll use a bow and arrow.
All right, Shane, look after yourself. Well, oh, some people find this job amusing.
Oh, she gave me a hiding at dusk last night.
Unlike some people, I have work to do.
I should have known better. Hey, look, since we've both off this afternoon and got a split shift, do you fancy going to a film?
What, and waste this weather? Let's go for a drive instead.
Okay, anywhere special?
I'll take your pick, but I promise I won't get you lost, stranger.
I'm in your hands, Mum.
Shot to expect a phone call from some jailbirds to change his mind about Edna.
Well, it might get him to think for a minute, you know, if in doubt, he'd out.
Oh,
well,
that's
true.
Got a visitor. Come on, I haven't got all day. Are you in a hurry, Warren?
Sorry, Miss Ferguson. The Woodville's gone.
I'd be very careful if I were you, Warren. Bumping into the wrong people can be quite dangerous. Milsom, out.
Of your mind bumping into the freak.
You've got to do something. You've got to help Bobbie.
Calm down. What's the matter
She's
with
Bobbie? She's
going
to kill herself.
Now listen, is this another one of your jokes?
I'm not kidding. Look, I was on a bed.
How? Did you realise she was this low?
So
well, you're going to stand there yucking. You're going to help me find her.
Okay, Jude, you check the showers and see if the boiler room's open. I'll check the rest of the dorms. You check the rec room. And walk. We don't want the screws in on this.
Next week.
And that only gives us a few days to prepare our case, so I won't waste time. I'll want you to plead guilty with diminished responsibility.
Maybe you think that's best?
Well, considering your emotional state at the time, I think we have a very good case. I've spoken to Rick Manning, and he will testify for you.
Is that necessary?
We need his evidence.
No, it's personal, Mr. Adams. I don't know how I'll feel about seeing Rick again. What are my chances?
Well, I can't guarantee an acquittal or even a suspended sentence. But if you are convicted, I'm sure we can get you into somewhere a little less grim than this place.
No, I don't want that.
Why not?
Look, Mr. Adams, if I have to do time, I'd rather do it in here where I've made a few friends.
If those are your instructions, then we won't pursue the matter in court.
It's the best I can hope for, isn't it? My choice of jails.
That's the worst that can happen. I'm being cautious with you, Rachel, not pessimistic.
Have you seen Bobbie?
No, she's in the laundry.
Oh, I've got to find her.
Settle down. How far away could she be?
I don't understand. She left the... Did you find her?
No, no luck.
Well, someone tell me what's going on.
Bobbie, she's gone missing. She's left a farewell note.
She's gonna chuck it in.
No. Not a sign. No one's seen her either.
Damn it, we've looked everywhere too.
Except the governor's office.
I asked to see Mrs. Reynolds 10 minutes ago and she's at lunch.
That leaves the roof.
You don't think she could have got up there?
She could.
Depends how desperate she was, doesn't it?
Get up there.
Come on. Supposed to be in the laundry.
Yeah. We're just looking for Bobbie.
Up here? Bobbie is in the infirmary with Sister Hall. I took her there myself.
We're too late, aren't we?
Too late for me.
It's my fault. We should have been quicker. I have to know, Mrs. M. How did she go? Was it quick?
It takes about 2 minutes to walk to the infirmary. Is that quick enough for you, Marlene?
You mean she walked there?
Bobbie has a headache, not a broken leg. Sister Hall's given her some aspirin. She's lying down. Now, would you mind telling me what all this is about?
Oh, nothing really, you know. We heard she wasn't feeling well. We thought we'd go and look for it.
Yeah, well, I suggest you all go back to the laundry.
Yeah, sure.
Sorry. Off with my head and long with my passion, eh?
No. I couldn't have known it was a false alarm, but I want you to do the right thing.
Still that note?
No, I think she's just depressed, that's all.
Maybe, maybe not.
You lot are mad about the beaches, aren't you? The next time I win, it'd be the dandy of pumps.
Boy, do you need a sunburn.
I saw him roll the thing, probably blind drunk. They usually are.
Did you call for help?
Oh, settle down, mate. It's nothing to do with me.
Jesus. You get your ass into gear and call a bloody ambulance, you dumb bitches. Come on.
Where do you think you are?
Now, forget it, mate. I had a go. She's jamming, right?
Oh, come on, the two of us can do it. Let's get him out of there.
No way. I've done my bit. He's probably dead anyway, or halfway there at least.
You don't know that. We can't just leave him there.
Dennis, it stings. There's exposed wires in there.
Spot on. That heaps the time bomb.
Get out of here. Oh.
Pack of bloody vampires.
I think you have a good chance, love.
Yeah, well, if I do get out, I won't miss this place. I will miss some of the people, though. Well, funny how you make friends, isn't it?
Yeah, and you need more than most in here. That's if you can afford them.
Oh, I wouldn't count my chickens if I were you, Rachel. Them legal eagles just take all your dough and leave you here to rot. There ain't no such thing as justice.
Oh, God, the friendly neighbourhood voice of doom.
Milsom, Farrah, will you go to the kitchen? Mrs. O'Regan needs some help. She's sick.
Well, Bobbie, your friends were very worried about you.
Not now that we can see her, Mrs. Morris.
Take over from Rachel, Bobbie. What was the problem?
There was no problem. I just had a headache.
What'd they give you?
Aspirin.
Did they give you anything extra?
Get off me back, will you?
Look, don't try and bottle it up, Bobbie. I found your note.
What note?
The suicide note, the one you left on the bed.
It was just a load of garbage.
Oh, yeah? What's this then? Why should I stick around? No one gives a stuff anyway.
So what? I was scribbling. I was just trying to get me head together. Leave me alone, all right?
Fair enough, love. Our mistake.
I know I've got a tire lever in here somewhere.
Dennis, can't you wait till the police get here? They'll be here any minute.
What do you mean, join the rest of the offside citizens and wait for the thing to blow? I mean, he's probably just unconscious. We've got to try.
live with myself. You're off your head, pal. It's leaking more petrol than an Arab dunny. Get out of here!
No, I can't! You can't get him out by yourself!
I said get out!
On the roast in the oven. What's your name again?
It's Rachel, Mrs. O'Regan.
Right. Dot, you can help her with the veggies. Oh, my head's like a balloon.
How often would you like the lamb basted?
Don't you go mucking around with it. Just make sure it doesn't burn.
You get no sense of her when she's like that.
She's ill.
Did you see the eyes, the way her hand shook? She's hitting the sauce again. I've seen it all before.
Take your word for it. What are the vegetables?
Cabbage and spuds again. All that peeling. Now, when I've got dermatitis...
Mashed and boiled. What's wrong with a bit of imagination?
From O'Regan. She can't even cook even when she's sober.
Mrs. O'Regan, I was wondering if I might do something different with the potatoes.
Such as?
Well, I thought maybe potato croquettes. I wouldn't mind the extra work.
Are you having a shot at my cooking?
Not at all.
This isn't the rich, you know. Just who do you think you are, some fancy chef?
No, but I thought if I was in here to help...
You're here to do as you're told. Just remember that. Prison's no place for fancy ideas.
Well, of course, nothing worthwhile could come from a prisoner.
Just suffer in silence, dear. That's my motto. After the first 10 years, you don't care anymore.
Take an early mark, Winter. Bell hasn't gone yet.
We need to talk business, just you and me.
When it suits me.
Well, I better suit you now. Just want to get a few points clear about how it's going to be when you're governor.
You know the deal.
Well, go on, humour me.
Right, you have a free hand, you run the rackets, we split 50-50. Anyone who gives any trouble gets transferred. You see, a nice, closed, profitable shop.
Bitch! It's me halfway to bloody Blackmore! Now, you will do as I say.
This is my turf.
You've been too bloody long here to elaborate. If I go to Blackmore, I'll make damn sure I have you for company. They'd love to know the real story behind the riot, wouldn't they? I believe you. Are you prepared to take that risk? All bets are off, Ferguson. I'm going to squeal till you hang. Because the way I figure it, I got nothing to lose. You got one way out of this. Just one.
What do you want?
I want out. And you're gonna arrange it.
No, not tomorrow. This afternoon. I want it cut down, the roots dug out and carted away. Right, thank you.
Organising your garden, eh? Personal business on prison time?
For your information, it was prison business. And in case you're interested, I have some new evidence on the Warren poisoning.
Eager little beaver, aren't you? Thought you'd be better off spending your time looking at the situations vacant.
As you well know, Joan, if they make you governor, I'll resign. Meanwhile, I hope we're both professional enough to still work together.
Right. Well, what about this new evidence?
Well, no one else got sick after that barbecue, and the meat that was left over was as fresh as a daisy, so that just about rules out food poisoning. Today I searched up near the barbecue area and I found a skewer made out of an oleander bush.
Oleander? That rings a bell.
Yes, it's a poisonous shrub. We've got one outside. I'm having it removed today.
So you're suggesting that someone has used this oleander skewer to poison Warren's steak? Oh, well, that puts the blame right on Mitchell, doesn't it?
No, it just... doesn't add up.
Well, I can think of a number of people who'd like to get rid of Warren. Justifiable homicide, I'd call it.
Mitchell wouldn't know the difference between an oleander and a buttercup, and neither would any of the other women. But one thing does stick in my mind.
What's that?
2 days ago, out in the garden, Edna Pearson was spouting on to all the women about gardening. and she named every plant she could see.
Well, maybe she was guilty. And you and the governor were so pleased when she was released.
I have been wrong before.
Many times. Anyway, it's all a waste of time. Your new evidence wouldn't stand up in a court of law.
I'm well aware of that, Joan.
Meg, a fistful of invoices just landed on my desk I know nothing about. Did you authorise them while I was out?
I authorised them. With what authority?
Well, when I'm appointed governor, there are certain things I'll need. I felt it was in the interest of efficiency to be prepared.
Once you're appointed, if you're appointed, you can and no doubt will do whatever the hell you like. But as long as I am governor, I will not be treated with contempt by you of all people. Make sure these are cancelled.
Only 24 hours to go, eh?
Yeah, then it's goodbye to Mrs. O'Regan's cottage pie.
Geez, who's going to look after the next fashion parade?
Oh.
Oh, I didn't mean that the way it sounded. I hope it goes really well tomorrow, Lee.
Oh, thanks. As far as the fashion parades are concerned, I think you're just about ready to fill my shoes.
Oh, I'm not that good in high heels.
Oh, don't we know it?
Something bugging you?
No.
Well, are we bugging you?
You care more about Rachel and Lee than you do about me. You know Murray must have pushed Reb, and you and Myra won't even back me up.
Now, that's not true. We can't do the impossible. She has an alibi.
Yeah, and I got no alibi and no mates either.
Okay. You might not think that we care about you, honey, but I got a letter here that shows that we really do care. Well, some of us... I'm going to read you this letter anyway. Dear Judy, I can't really enjoy being free yet because I miss you all so much. My first night on the outside was terrible. I cried all night wondering about Bobbie and her baby. How is Bobbie? I went to the hospital where they're keeping Cass. They wouldn't let me see her. But I spoke to the doctor and there's good news. She's gonna be all right.
Oh, man.
Please look after one another. All my love, Pixie.
She really is something, isn't she?
She sure is. There's a P.S. I still have my job at the bridal boutique. I'm having a wonderful time there, especially since I found out Mr. Schumann has a nephew. And guess what? She says he's not married.
Will she ever learn?
I don't think so. But she sure taught us one thing. Please look after each other.
Oh, there you are. I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Yes. Changing my shirt, in fact.
Dennis just saved a man's life from a car crash. He nearly got killed.
Really? I've heard worse excuses for being late.
Ring the Edith Vale police if you don't believe me.
Let it go, Heather. It's not worth it.
But you were a hero. Some people just wouldn't appreciate that.
Be very careful who I spoke to in that tone of voice, Rogers. The fact remains that both of you are late. Therefore, the buy-up that you should have distributed this afternoon will have to wait until after dinner.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Then hurry it up. There are other officers doing your jobs.
Oh, boy. Oh,
take it easy.
I'd really like to tell her what I think of her.
Well, not today, Charlie. Did you notice the ministerial car that pulled up outside? Odds are we'll have a new governor by stumps. Worse luck.
Oh, Mrs. M, what can I do for you?
I just had a call from Kay.
No, don't worry. Just want to know if you got that letter she sent you.
Ah.
She sounded very chirpy. Said she's keeping an eye on Alan, and he seems to be helping her, too. So far, so good.
So far, so good.
And she wanted me to tell you again how much she loves you for what you did. She knows what it cost you.
Yeah, she doesn't know what it cost the others, though, does she? Cass's breakdown, Bobbie losing the baby. Maybe, if I'd been here.
Well, off the record, and knowing all that, I think I would have done exactly the same if it had been Marty instead of Kay.
Mrs. Reynolds got the bullet because of what happened while I was away, didn't she?
I think you'll all regret that if Joan does take over. I, for one, will certainly not be staying, and neither will many of the other officers either.
We'll be very sorry if you do go, Mrs. M. But that's not going to stop Joan Ferguson. She'll bring in the Gestapo if she has to. Can't blame you if you do leave.
Well, do have my integrity to protect. And you did save Kay's life.
We've got to serve in 15 minutes. Get a move on.
The meat isn't ready yet.
I don't care if it's raw. Get it on the bench and start carving.
Well, if you don't get a move on, we may as well serve the meat with a flaming dessert. Me veggies are all getting cold.
It is hot, you know.
Well, it's just a question of knowing what you're doing. I could have had it all done by now, even with me 2 feet in the grave.
Be my guest.
Well, typical. No ones today. Wouldn't work in an iron lung.
You're supposed to be doing the spuds.
We swap jobs.
Well, I didn't tell you to swap.
Can't do everything all at once, can I?
Oh! Can't really tell my mum and dad about that maniac trying to poison me, can I? Hope her husband wakes up to himself. I'm really sorry about carrying on like a chook with its head cut off today. It must have been really thick to think you'd really do yourself in.
You know, I reckon we've got to be mates, daughter. So if I tell you something, will you promise to keep it to yourself?
Oh, look, I've got a really big mouth, but I can't keep a secret, you know?
Well, you were right.
What about?
I was gonna do it.
You're having me on.
I faked the headache just to get into the infirmary. Couldn't even pinch the right bloody pills, could I? Vitamins. It's my luck to stuff everything up.
You don't still feel like doing it, do you?
Don't feel anything now. I won't try it again.
Look, Bobbie. With his life, his hope, all that stuff. And you might talk the VJ into letting your parole go through.
What good will that do me? Nothing for me in here. Nothing for me outside.
You might get yourself a really good job.
900,000 unemployed. I read it. You know where the ex-crims are? End of the line. I've got no baby. No bloke. The only thing I've got to sell is me body. The only place I can call home is a cell in this stinking prison.
Look, you ought to have a good talk with Judy and Myra. They think the world of you, you know?
Oh, yeah, sure. They're always on me back about something. I'm not gonna tell them. Neither are you. Keep your mouth shut.
The department can't always act as it would like to, Anne. The acting minister has to take public opinion into account, too. And it seems it pays to have influential friends close to the powers that be.
Yes, I imagine it does.
You asked to see me, Governor?
Miss Ferguson, this is the minister's secretary, Mr. Watkins.
I'm pleased to meet you, Miss Ferguson.
It is.
This concerns the post of governor at this prison. Your application was most favourably received, I might say.
Well, thank you, Mr. Watkins.
However, Mrs. Reynolds' heroism during the recent prison riot and the subsequent favourable press coverage have caused us to reconsider and reinstate Mrs. Reynolds as governor with the full endorsement of the department.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes,